Parliament has sealed the fate of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, after approving the controversial National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024. With a few amendments, the bill was passed without the majority of the opposition members in the House. The few who remained, such as Nandala Mafabi, could not do much to save the controversial transfer of UCDA back to the Agriculture Ministry. The opposition, led by the Leader of Opposition in Parliament, Joel Senyonyi, walked out protesting the suspension of their 12 colleagues, whom Speaker Nita Mong accused of orchestrating the disruption of plenary. Pandemonium broke out in the House after MP Francis Zake Mityande Municipality aggressively approached MP Anthony Akol of Kilak North FDC and forcibly shoved him from his seat near the Speaker. In response, Akol punched Zake in the head before being restrained.
Honorable members, the Sergeant at Arms, has changed. And there is nothing. Corner.
To diffuse the chaos, Speaker Mong quickly adjourned the House for 15 minutes, retreating to restore order. When the House resumed, the Speaker apologized for the events and suspended several MPs. A debate of the bill proceeded and was eventually passed with a few amendments, especially clauses relating to the powers of the minister.
I put a question that a clause 12 be amended as proposed. Those in favor stand the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
Clause 12 as amended.
I put a question that clause 12 as amended stands part of the bill.
There is no need for the ministry to be mandated to promote consumption of coffee by law.
For purposes of this section, the authority shall conduct awareness on coffee consumption, conduct behavior change communication among the public to encourage the drinking of coffee, and three, build the capacity of local roasters, coffee baristas, coffee brewers, and any other stakeholders.
That now we want the ministry to be the advertising agent for people who are producing coffee locally.
Agriculture Minister Frank Tumwebaze assured Ugandans that the ministry will ensure that the coffee value chain is developed and exports continue gaining the international market. The passing of the National Coffee Amendment Bill 2024 now reshapes the country's coffee regulatory framework. The 10th witness in the murder case of Henry Katanga testified today in the High Court presided over by Justice Isaac Mwata. AIP Kanene Enoch testified before court about his involvement in examining the exhibits, which included mobile phones belonging to the accused persons. He said that his task was to establish if there was a link between the phones and the murder that was committed.
My Lord, the request contained three exhibits. The stamps were marked as A.
He added that he filed a report regarding the findings to this effect. The prosecution, led by Jonathan Mwaganya, requested to lay this report before the court and add it to the file as part of the exhibits to the defense testimony. However, the defense lawyers, led by Elision Karuanga, objected to the prayer, saying that the 10th witness conducted the investigations illegally.
The law is clear. He cannot have their stuff without an extension after 72 hours.
He added that AIP Kanene was not authorized by the court to confiscate the said mobile phones and investigate the transactions. The judge adjourned the case hearing to tomorrow to allow enough time for the prosecution side to respond as asked by Assistant DPP Samali Waholi.
We need the time to prepare our response. He has actually submitted for almost also 1 full hour.
Let's start tomorrow morning.
Much obliged.
Donald Trump has won the U.S. presidential election, defeating Kamala Harris in a stunning political comeback that will send shockwaves across the world. The polarizing Republicans' victory following one of the most hostile campaigns in modern U.S. history was all the more remarkable given an unprecedented criminal conviction, a near-miss assassination attempt, and warnings from a former chief of staff that he is a fascist.
As we're going to help our country heal. We're going to help our country heal. We have a country that needs help, and it needs help very badly. We're going to fix our borders. We're going to fix everything about our country. And we made history for a reason tonight, and the reason is going to be just that.
Results put him on the verge of one of the most stunning comebacks in the U.S. political history.